Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to Technology Explore. In this video I am going to show you how you can make a floating water wheel in SolidWorks. At the end we will also create this type of small animation. So keep watching this video till end, and if you are interested to download these parts for your practice, I will leave the download link in the description of this video. Keep watching this video till end. Let's start. First of all, I am going to make the runner for this turbine. So for that, sketch on front plane. Then draw two circles and start them from origin. Define the diameter of outer circle is 500 mm and the diameter for inner circle is 100 mm. Then go to features tab and apply extruded boss base command. Extrusion thickness is 20 mm and press OK button. Then click on this face and sketch on it. Make normal 2 and then draw 3-point arc and start it from here like this. Now press escape button and then define total width of this line or arc. It is 100 mm. Then press escape button and from here select origin and this point. Make their relation vertical. Now drag this arc like this. Now select this circular edge and this point. Make their relation coincident. Then define the distance from this point up to this point, and at this time add this distance. It is 15 mm. Now define the radius of this arc. It is 155 mm. So this sketch is fully defined. Go to features tab and from here select extruded boss base command. Scroll down and so automatically the system has checked in thin features. Drop down this option and from here select mid plane. Thickness of this thin feature is 5 mm. Total extrusion length is also 500 mm. Then press OK button. Now click on this arrow below the linear pattern command and from here select circular pattern. Select this circular edge as a pattern axis and then click on this box features and faces and select this extrusion. So the quantity is 25. Make sure the equal spacing option is checked in. Then press OK button. After that, click on this face and then sketch on it. Make normal 2 and expand this boss extrude 1 and select its sketch. Then press this button convert entities. Now again extrude it up to 20 mm in the opposite direction and press OK button. So this was the runner. Now save this part. Now start from new part again, and at this time I'm going to design shaft. So sketch on front plane. Now draw a sketch by using line command and start it from origin. Press escape button, then select both of these lines, make their relation equal and collinear. Similarly, same relation for these lines, equal and collinear. Then select this point and this midpoint. Make their relation vertical. After that, define this diameter or radius and it is 55 mm. This radius is 50 mm. This radius is 25 mm. Define this length 460 mm. This length is 20 mm, and this length is 200 mm. So our sketch is fully defined. Go to Features tab and apply Revolved Boss Base command. Select this line as a axis of revolution and press OK button. Save this shaft. Now once again start from a new part, and at this time I am going to design bearing. So sketch on front plane, then draw a center line, start it from origin. Press escape button, then draw two rectangles, one at this point and one rectangle at this point. Again press escape button. Select all these four lines, make their relation equal. Similarly, select this line and this line, make their relation equal and collinear. Now define the bore diameter 50 mm, and now define this the length of this line, and it is 15 mm. Define this outer diameter of the bearing 120 mm. Now define this width, and it is 40 mm. Press escape button. Now draw a center line and start it from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Press escape button, and now draw a circle on this midpoint. Now define the diameter of this circle, and it is 30 mm. Now use trim entities command from here and trim this line, also these two lines, then this circle from here and also from here. Now press escape button, and then go to Features tab and apply Revolved Boss Base command. Select this center line as axis of revolution and press OK button. So now sketch on front plane again, make normal 2, and from here change the shade, then draw a circle. Start it from the center point like this. Define the diameter of this circle, and it is 30 mm. Then draw a line and start it from this point. Press escape button and trim this side of the circle. Again use Revolved Boss Base command and select this line as a axis of revolution, or press OK button. Now change the shade again. Now click on this arrow below the linear pattern, and from here select circular pattern. Select this pattern axis box and then select this circular edge. Then check to this box bodies and select this ball. Type here the quantity 8 and press OK button. Now select this revolve 2 and circular pattern 1. Then change the appearance. Once again start from new part, and at this time I am going to design the floating pads. So sketch on front plane, then use line command to draw this sketch. Press escape button and then use 3-point arc and press escape button. Define it. This width or height is 100 mm, and this length is 2 m. Press escape button. Rearrange the sketch. Now define the radius of this arc. It is 6660. Define this length 1000 or 1 meter. So our sketch is now fully defined. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Boss Base command. Extrusion length is also 100 millimeter. Press OK button. Now sketch on this face. Make normal to, and then draw some circles. And press Escape button. Now select all the circles and make them equal. Then select this midpoint and this center point of the circle. Make their relation horizontal. Then again select both of these midpoints or center points and make their relation vertical. Similarly, for these two circles the relation is vertical. Make the relation for these two circles horizontal. Also make horizontal relation for these circles. Now define the diameter of the circle, and it is 30 millimeter. Press Escape button. Now draw a center line and start it from this center point up to this center point. Select this midpoint and this center point. Make their relation vertical. Again draw a center line from this center point up to this center point. Select this midpoint and this center point. Make their relation horizontal. Now define this length is 60 millimeter. This length is 250 millimeter. Distance from this line up to this point is 50 millimeter. So our sketch is now fully defined. Press OK button and go to Features tab. Apply Extruded Boss Base command. Extrusion length is 600 millimeter. Press OK button. Now click on Linear Pattern command here, and then in the direction 1 select this line. Click on this box Features to Pattern, and then expand these options. From here select Boss Extrude 2. Scroll up, and in the direction 1 we need 2 instances, and the distance between them is 500 millimeter. So we have to reverse the direction. Click on this button for reverse direction and press OK button. Now click on this face and then sketch on it. Expand the Boss Extrude 1 and select its sketch. From here select Convert Entities, and then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Boss Base command. Extrusion length is 100 millimeter. Press OK button. So next step is that we have to create a space for bearing on the floating pad. So for that, sketch on this face and then make normal to, then draw a rectangle. Start it from here like this. One more rectangle. Then press Escape button and click and drag your mouse on this direction, not on this direction. So by doing that you will only select these two lines. Now make their relation equal and collinear. Now select these four lines and at this time drag your mouse in this direction and then make their relation equal. Now define this width is 200 millimeter, and the distance from this line up to this point is 50 millimeter. So sketch is fully defined. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Boss Base command. Extrusion length or height is 200 mm. Then press OK button. So next step is that click on this face and then sketch on it. Make normal to, and then draw a center line started from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Press escape button and then draw a circle on this midpoint. Define the diameter of this circle and it is 100 mm. Then go to features tab and apply extruded cut command. So in the direction 1, extrude it up to 40 mm, and in the direction 2, extrude it up to 640 mm, and press OK button. Again, sketch on this face, make normal to, and change the shade. Then draw a circle on this center point. Define the diameter of this circle, 50 mm. Change the shade and then go to features tab and apply again extruded cut command. Double click on this face and then press OK button. So next step is that we have to make or design a platform for the generator. For that, click on this face and then sketch on it. Make normal to, and then draw a rectangle like this. Define it. This width is 500 mm, and distance from this line up to this line is 100 mm. Now go to features tab again and extrude it in the reverse direction up to 200 mm, and press OK button. Now one last step is that we have to apply the fillet on these corners. So for that, select fillet command from here, and then fillet radius is 30 mm. Now select this edge, this edge, this edge, and this edge. Then press OK button. Again use fillet command and then select this edge, this edge. Also select both of these edges. Fillet radius is 100 mm or 100 mm, and press OK button. Once again select fillet command and then select this edge and this edge. Also select these two edges and press OK button. One last fillet for these edges. And press OK button. Save this part. Now we have to make a generator. So again, start from new part. Sketch on front plane. And then draw a circle on origin. Define the diameter of this circle and it is 300 mm. Again draw a circle on the origin. Define its diameter and it is 50 mm. Go to features tab and apply extruded boss base command. Extrusion length is 500 mm, or instead of 500 type here 400 mm. Then press OK button. Now click on this face and then sketch on it. Make normal to, and then draw a line like this. Press escape button. Define the height of this line, 200 mm, and then define the distance from origin to this point, 148 mm. So now go to Features tab and apply Extruded Bow Space command. In the thin features, the extrusion width is 5 mm, and then drop down these options. From here, select mid plane. Then double click on this face and press OK button. Now select circular pattern from here and then select this box pattern axis and select this circular edge. Now click on this box features to pattern and select this extrude thin 2. Type here the quantity 50 and press OK button. Now click on this face and sketch on it. Make normal 2 and then draw a sketch by using line command and start it from here. Press escape button, then make this line horizontal. After that, select this point, this midpoint and origin. Make their relation vertical. Then select this line and this line, make their relation equal and collinear. Now define the total width 400 mm, width of this line 20 mm, height of this line 10 mm. Then select these two lines and make them equal. Now define the distance from this line to the origin, 180 mm. So our sketch is now fully defined. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Bow Space command. Then double click on this face and press OK button. So we have to edit this sketch again. Expand the bow extrude 2 and then select sketch 3 and edit it. Edit this dimension 50 mm. Now press save and exit from the sketch button. So the generator casing is designed. Save it. Now we have to design the shaft for the generator. Again, start from new part and sketch on front plane. Draw a sketch by using line command. Press escape button. Define total length. It is 550 mm. Then define this height and it is 20 mm. Go to Features tab and apply Revolved Bow Space command. Select this line as axis of revolution and press OK button. Again, sketch on front plane, make normal 2. And then draw a line like this. Press escape button. Now draw 3-point arc. Now define this height is 200 mm. This width is 50 mm. Press escape button and rearrange and this arc. Click on this point and then delete the coincident relation. Distance from this point up to this point, it is 20 mm. So now again apply Revolved Bow Space command. Select this line as axis of revolution and press OK button. Now click on this face and sketch on it. Make normal 2 and then draw 3-point arc and start it from origin up to this circle. press escape button and define the radius of this arc. It is 400 millimeter. Press escape button and then go to features tab and apply extruded bore space command. Double click on this face, then scroll down from here, and in the thin features, the width of thin feature is 2 millimeter. Drop down these options and select mid plane and press OK button. Similarly, again use a circular pattern, select pattern access box and then select this circular edge. Now select features, drop down these options and from here select extrude thin 1. Type here the quantity 40 and press OK button. Once again, sketch on front plane, make normal 2 and then use 3-point arc and start it from this point to the origin. Define the radius of the arc 350 millimeter and then define the distance from this point to this point. It is 5 millimeter. Press escape button and then draw a line. Like this. And press escape button. Now in the features tab, use revolved cut command. Select this line. And press OK button. So now select circular pattern 1 and extrude thin 1. Change the appearance and press OK button. Similarly, select revolve 2 and change its appearance. Now select revolve 1 and change its appearance. Save this shaft. So one last part is the pulley. Sketch on front plane and then draw a center line, start it from origin. Then again draw a line like this. Now press escape button and then define this diameter 100 millimeter. This diameter is 500 millimeter. Press escape button, select this line and this line, make their relation equal and collinear. Then select this midpoint and this midpoint, make their relation vertical. Now define this width 100 millimeter, this width 30 millimeter, this height 20 millimeter. Press escape button, then select this point and origin, make their relation vertical. So this sketch is fully defined. Go to features tab and apply revolved bore space command. Press OK button. Click on this face and sketch on it. Make normal 2 and then draw a circle. Define the diameter of this circle 100 millimeter and then select origin and this center point. Make their relation vertical. Define the height from origin to this center point 130 millimeter. Then apply extruded cut command. Extrude it, cut it from throughout this pulley. Then again apply circular pattern and then select this box and identify this circular edge. Now click on this box features to pattern and then select cut extrude 1. Type here the quantity 4 and press OK button. So save this pulley. Now last pulley for the generator. Open this pulley and for turbine and expand revolve 1, edit its sketch, make normal 2, select all these entities and copy them by pressing Ctrl plus C button. Then go to new part and sketch on front plane, paste, then select this point and the origin, make their relation coincident. Then edit this dimension, instead of 100, type here 50 mm. Also edit this dimension 300 mm, and then go to features tab and apply revolve pose space command. Press OK button. Again sketch on this face, make normal 2, and then click on this arrow in front of straight slot. And then from here select center point arc slot. Click on the origin and then draw it like this. Now define the distance from this circle up to the arc, and it is 75 mm. Define this distance 30 mm. Now define this distance, and it is 100 mm. Now go to features tab and apply extruded cut command. Cut it from throughout. Press OK button. Circular pattern it. Expand these options and from here select extrude cut 1, quantity is 3, press OK button. Save this part, generator pulley. Now let's assemble all these parts in SolidWorks assemblies. So instead of importing all these parts one by one, close this dialog and open the folder where you had saved all these parts. Select all these parts and then drop them in the SolidWorks assembly. Right click on the floating bed and make it fix. Then change the appearances of all parts. So I had changed the appearances of all these parts. Now let's assemble them one by one. So first of all, we have to assemble the bearing on the floating pad. So as you can see, I am unable to move this bearing because this bearing is in fixed position. Right click on it, and then from here select float. Now you can move it. Right click on the bearing and drag your mouse to rotate it according to the assembly. Then as you know, we need two bearings, so we have to make the duplicate of this bearing. Press and hold Ctrl key and then click and drag the bearing to make its duplicate. Now again press and hold Ctrl key and select this face and select this face, make their relation concentric. Again select this face and this cylindrical face, make their relation concentric. Then so we have to edit the diameter of this bore for floating pad. So for that, click on this floating pad and open it. From here select this bore and edit the sketch. Type here the diameter 120 mm and then save and exit from sketch. Now again go to assembly. You can also switch the SolidWorks tabs by pressing Ctrl key and then tab button. So now it is okay. Again Planes like this face or this face and this face make their relation coincident. Then select this face and this face make their relation coincident. Now we have to assemble the shaft. So for that, select this face of the shaft and this cylindrical face of bearing. Make their relation concentric. Then select this face, and this face of shaft. Make width mate. So again we have to edit the dimension of the shaft. So I'm sorry for that, because I'm designing this part without any drawings. Open the shaft, then expand revolve 1 and edit the sketch. Make normal 2. Now edit this dimension 560. Then exit from sketch and go to the assembly. So now this is okay. Next step is that we have to assemble the runner on the shaft. So select this cylindrical face of runner and then select mate. Then select this cylindrical face of the shaft. So we have to reverse the direction of runner. Click on this button, flip mate alignment. So basically water will strike from this side. Then lock the rotation and press OK button. Press OK button again. So once again we have to create width mate. So for that, select all these four faces. And then from here make width mate. Now attach the pulley on the shaft. Select this cylindrical face and then from here select mate. Mate it with the shaft, lock the rotation and press OK button. Now select this face and this face and press OK button. Again press OK button. Once again there is a mistake in the bore size of pulley. Again we have to edit it. Expand revolve 1 and edit sketch 1. Edit this diameter 50 mm and then save and exit from sketch. Now go to assembly. So this is okay now. Similarly, now assemble this shaft on the generator. So select this cylindrical face of shaft and this cylindrical bore of the generator. Make their relation concentric. Then select this face and this face. Make the distance mate. Type the distance 10 mm and press OK button. Now assemble this pulley on the shaft. So click on this cylindrical face and then select mate. Now select this cylindrical face. Lock the rotation and press OK button. Now select this face and this face and press OK button. Then select this face of the pulley and this face of this pulley. Make coincident mate and then make a coincident mate for this face and this face. Press OK button. Now select this face and this face. At this time make distance mate and type the distance 150 millimeter. Press OK button. Now press OK button again. Now there is another mistake in the diameter of this fan. So open this part and then expand revolve 2 and edit the sketch 3. Type here 150. Exit from sketch. Now go to assembly again. So this is okay now. If I try to rotate it, so this is okay. Now one last step is that we have to create belt for these pulleys. So for that, click on this arrow below the assembly features and from here select belt and chain. Select this cylindrical face and this cylindrical face. From here scroll down and check this box, create belt part, and press OK button. Now expand the belt one, also expand this part belt, and from here click on the sketch and edit it. Then go to features tab and apply extruded boss base command. From here drop down these options and select mid plane. Extrusion thickness is 30 mm. Check this box, thin features. Extrusion thickness is for thin feature thickness is 20 mm, and make sure the direction of extrusion is upward. So if it appears in this direction, click on this button and press OK button. Now click on this sketch and hide it. Then change the appearance of this belt. Press OK button. So finally our floating turbine is ready. You can rotate it. It is working. Exit from part editing mode. Then press this button, rebuild. So now let me show you how you can make its animation. First of all, select the view orientation for your model and then click on this button, motion study. Click on motor button here, then select this face of the shaft. Flip the direction of rotation. Scroll down. Type here the RPM 10, then press OK button. From here set the playback mode and this is the speed of the animation. Press calculate button. So this is how we can make a floating turbine or floating water wheel in SolidWorks. I hope you had enjoyed and learned from this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe this YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and sparing time.